Welcome to this brief guide on how to generate disposable email addresses using Terminal. Have you ever found yourself being asked to provide an email address to a site just to download something or activate a free trial and don't feel comfortable sharing your actual email address? Many people will look to potentially unsafe websites to help them create a temporary email address. Today, I'm going to walk you through an easy-to-use tool that allows you to safely do this from the terminal. The tool is called Mailsy and is available via the NPM Package Manager on Windows and via Brew on macOS. I will walk through installing it on both in this video and how to use it. Mailsy allows us to quickly and easily generate a new, random email address, fetch any emails that have been sent to this address, and then delete the account once we are finished with it. And all these features are done with easy-to-remember commands. But first, we need to install the tool. On Windows, this means firstly installing the NPM Package Manager if we don't already have it installed. To do this, open the Terminal app on your PC and run the following command, which I will have in the description below. Winget install OpenJS.NodeJS. This installation only needs to be run once, but will prompt you for administrator privileges to complete the installation. So be sure to approve it when prompted. Once completed, we want to run the following command to install Mailsy. npm install mailsy-g. But you will need to open either a new tab or window in Terminal, as the command will not succeed if you run it directly after installing npm. This is different to installing on macOS, which we will walk through next, and then we will show the tool in action. Here we are now on macOS. We need to start by ensuring Homebrew is installed. This is a package manager for macOS, similar to winget and npm on Windows. You can find the installation command for Homebrew via the site brew.sh, but I will also include it in the description below. Running this command will require you to enter your administrator password to proceed, similar to how Windows asked for administrator rights. Once entered, you will be advised as to what is going to be installed. Press enter to continue with the installation. The installation process won't take too long to complete, and once done, you will see installation successful in the output. We can now use Brew to install the Mailsy tool. We don't need to open up a new window or tab though in order to do this with the following command. Brew install Mailsy. Just like on Windows, it'll only take a few moments to complete the installation. And we are now ready to begin using the tool. I'll start by tidying up my terminal window with the command clear. And to create a temporary email address with Mailsy, we use the command mailsy-g. These commands will be the same when being run on Windows. And in a few seconds, we now have a new temporary email address we can use. But sometimes when you sign up to a site, they require you to provide a verification code that they send to this address. This is where the next command comes in. This command allows us to fetch any mail that has been sent to this address. Mailsy M. And we can see that an email has been sent to the address. If there were multiple emails, we can use our arrow keys to move up and down the list. Hitting enter on the selected email will open the email in a new browser window for us to view. The email is opened as an HTML file, so graphics and other elements will load as expected. Once we are done with the address and no longer require it, we can run the following command to delete the email address completely. Mailsy-d. And within seconds, the email address has been deleted. And if you ever need to recall which command does what, you can use the following command to open the help information. Mailsy-h. This will detail each command and what it does. And that is how you can use the Terminal application to easily generate temporary email addresses as needed. I hope you found this tip extremely useful and it serves you well in the future. And I'll catch you in my next video.
Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel. And if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.